Hello, I'm Carolyn, and I'd like to welcome you to our course on machine learning for business professionals. I lead a team of machine learning engineers who have successfully implemented many machine learning projects across various industries. In this course, you will learn what machine learning is and how to recognize machine learning use cases to solve business problems. You will also learn how to prepare for machine learning and implement successful projects. There is no math in this course. It is meant for a non-technical audience. We promise to use straightforward language and minimize the jargon, but at the same time, to still provide you with enough information to be successful at identifying and carrying out machine learning use cases. In your job, you will sometimes do ML projects all by yourself, but often you will be part of a team. This course is appropriate for a variety of roles in the modern business. For everyone on your team, whether you are a manager, or a technical writer, or a programmer, or a salesperson, or a data scientist. We expect that you are familiar with computers and are interested in using computers to solve business problems. If you're watching this video online, you meet our prerequisites. Welcome. As a business professional, you are part of an enterprise organization, and your organization has a mission. At Google, our mission is to organize the world's information and make it universally accessible and useful. At Home Depot, their goal is to provide the highest level of service, the broadest selection of products, and the most competitive prices to people in the home improvement business. At the World Wildlife Fund, their mission is to stop the degradation of the planet's natural environment and to build a future in which humans live in harmony with nature. Your company has a mission. As a business professional, you may want to further that mission. Often, your team's mission might be smaller, but still advance that goal. Perhaps your team's mission is to provide a particular service, and your personal mission is to improve customer satisfaction. My mission within Google, for example, is to transform through ML. In this course, you will learn about an exciting new technology, not for technology's sake, but to further the mission of your organization. You'll learn how to formulate machine learning solutions to real-world problems, identify whether the data you have is sufficient for ML, carry a project through various ML phases, including training, evaluation, and deployment, perform AI responsibly and avoid reinforcing existing bias, discover ML use cases, and be successful at ML. Most of all, this is a course on ML in practice, as it is employed in industry today. This is a non-technical course. If you are technical, you'll learn about the factors affecting the business success of your ML efforts. If you are a manager or decision maker, you will learn how to decide where to apply ML in your organization so you can get the best return on your investment. But the key thing you will learn is to solve business problems using ML. ML is a tool. Let's learn how to use it in your business. In order to do our first activity, I need to share two concepts I use to assess ML use cases. The first concept is difficulty, and the insight is that in order to transform your business with ML, you should think about goals that are challenging but not impossible. For example, if you're a manufacturing business, the question, "How could we produce perfect products each time?" is nearly impossible. There will always be some defects. On the other hand, how could we predict whether our assembly line is moving is too simple. How could we reduce the number of accidents on our factory floor is just right. The second concept you need to use to assess ML use cases is specificity. Just like with difficulty, there's a sweet spot between too open and too specific that allows teams to establish a heading but not get derailed by obstacles. How could we have no safety violations in our company is very open. Companies might have many different types of safety violations that are qualitatively different from each other. How could we reduce accidents caused by operator negligence is on the other end of the spectrum. It is too narrow and specific. Surely there are other kinds of accidents too. But how could we reduce the number of accidents on our factory floor is just right. For this activity, you practice rating a number of ML use cases and discussing those ratings with your fellow students on the forums. for each use case, determine its rating with respect to difficulty and specificity. I like to think of use cases as living in a two-dimensional space, like the one you see here.